So what we want to do is keep you understanding that when we come around, we have the orbit. The orbit is set here in our pillar one, our start. That's what we call as the beginning of the chain reaction. This is why the windup is so, so critical. So one of the things we're going to do is that when we wind and we're creating this, we're setting the orbit of the discus. Now, we can be anywhere technically in here. There are throwers who have had lower. John Powell was a thrower that used to carry the discus a little bit lower. He would talk about putting that discus up on the shelf. I think a lot of throwers like that discuss that, and the high point is key. But one of the things is we're going to look at is we're going to understand that if we set that orbit here and this arm is following this way, we're naturally going to start to create that orbit that comes around. So it's kind of a gradual thing. And so one of the reasons we don't teach in our system is to just put it up there is that a lot of throwers, a lot of beginning, less dynamic guys that are going to develop, or girls that are going to develop on a slower timeline, are going to wind up pushing their hip too much. And when they push the hip, they get the break at the waist that actually pushes the shin back, and they're going to come into the throw, and they're actually, many of them are going to be dropping and scooping. So one of the things we want to do is we want to understand how to keep that discus away. So one of the simple tips is that you want to think about how we have a gradual path. So when we're here and the arm's here, we have to avoid the high arm. We want the arm reaching out long and around. That's going to pull the thrower into the circle, and that's going to help them switch. This is, again, what we refer to as pillar three and four. So when we do that, we call the axis transition. We're also hitting that high point. We're hitting the discus down here. And one of the things you're going to notice when I show you this is, what am I showing you? My discus is actually really at shoulder height. It's the angle of the body in this position that's creating the high point. So when we talk about our pillar four, which is our axis transition, where we twist, wrap, and we're hitting the high point, we're setting this position, we're creating that power position angle, which is gonna take that discus out here. As we drive, we push and rotate the delivery side out, and we get that discus out here, and we hit that really nice finish. That's how you start to feel that length. So staying relaxed with the arms is one of the simple ways to do that. Setting the path right out of what we start, our start or pillar one, as we move through the throw, and we see how it's that gradual turning of how we transition the axis around and then again around and out. So we hit that high point that allows the thrower to move over the delivery leg to this point and come through the throw.